Dear Blender Wizards, welcome back to the second and last episode of the Harry Potter wand creation in Blender. On the first episode, we modeled this decent wand, and in this episode, we're gonna work on some scene setups and give it a realistic, decent materials, as you see here. That's amazing, isn't it? But before we start, I'm gonna give you a challenge and an opportunity. After watching this two-episode tutorial completely, let's try to make your own style of wand and send it to me to chaakoraa.productions@gmail.com. In that case, I will choose the best ones and reveal them in my upcoming videos and also rate your artworks in the beginning of my videos. In that case, your artworks will get the chance to be seen and featured in the channel videos. Okay, that's it. I can't wait anymore. Let's go to the Blender and wrap up this tutorial. The material that I use for the handle part and the stick part of the wand is this dark wood material from polyhaven.com, and I highly recommend you to download the 4K version of that in the case of getting the highest quality. And I put the link in the description, it's completely free, so you can go along and follow with the tutorial. First of all, let's go to the render part and change your render engine from EV to cycles and CPU to GPU if you have one. It will make your render process really faster. And I have to mention that it will work pretty well with EV as well, this tutorial, so you can go along with EV and won't have any problems. So let's come all the way down to color management and change the look from none to a high contrast. In that case, it will give you a much more contrasty and interesting looking like in your render result. So let's add a camera, press Shift A and add a camera. And let's find a good view for our camera. I wanna take the render from this view, and when you're satisfied with the view, just press Ctrl+Alt+0. In that case, it will snap the view to your camera as well. So press N and just lock the camera to the view. In that case, you can navigate in your viewport and camera at the same time, so it will make your process very, you know, convenient for you. Okay, that will be good for me. Press N again and let's disable the lock the camera to the view option in the case of not moving the camera coincidentally, and press N to close up this panel. So it will be our camera. And let's split the view part into two sections. Press T here to close up this panel and press 0 to go to the camera view, and let's change this to a render preview part. Okay. So I'm gonna add two lights, one the main light and one the support light. Let's press Shift A and bring an area light and bring it higher a little bit. Press 1 to go to front of the graphic view to see properly, and let's rotate that a little bit and bring it to the right part, or maybe we can rotate that even more like that. And press 7 to see it from the top of the graphic view. Press S, Y to scale it on the Y direction and up to the point that it covers all the shape like that, and come all the way down to data part and change the power of the light to something around 80, and this would be our main light. And press 1 again to go to the front or the graphic view. Press Shift D, bring another one, take a copy to the left part, let's rotate that and bring that a little bit farther from the shape, and there we go. So this would be the support light. Because of that, we have to decrease the power of it. 80 is a lot for that. Maybe we'll go with 30. And the color should be a cool color, like a pale blue color and something like this. I like the effect. Okay, so let's change this part from viewport, 3D viewport, to a shader editor. Press N to close up this panel. And I'm going to start with the marble part. Select the marble part and click on new here to add a new material. And I'm going to change the name to marble. So it is a procedural material. We don't need any pictures. We're going to make the material inside the blender. So press Shift A to add a noise texture. And with the noise texture selected, press Ctrl T to add to mapping nodes and the texture coordinate node. And I'm going to change this generator to object of the texture coordinate and plug the color to the base color. If Ctrl T doesn't work for you, it's because of the node wrangler add-on. So you can just come to edit, preferences, and on the add-ons, search for the node wrangler and just enable that. In that case, it will work for you as well. So As soon as you plug the color to the base color, you see that it's colorful effect here, but we don't need that colorful one, so we're gonna change the color. So press Shift A and bring a color ramp node and plug it in between the noise texture and principal BSDF. And as soon as you plug that, you see that it's changed to black and white, and we exactly want this effect here. So let's close these ones, make these ones close together a little bit. Let's zoom in to see it properly. And I think we're gonna go on with that kind of, you know, options. And let's increase the scale just a little bit, around maybe 9 and something like that. And let's increase the detail all the way to 15, and maybe a little bit roughness, just like that. And I'm gonna change the colors. The black one should be a something brownish color like this, and this one also should be a creamy color, and it shouldn't be that saturated like that. I like the effect. And let's select all of them and bring it a little bit to the right left part, and press Shift D and bring another color ramp node for the roughness, and plug the color to the roughness, and plug the color of the color ramp to first color ramp to the second one. And in that case, it will control the roughness of the shape. Let's zoom in a little bit to see it properly, and I'm gonna just make it reflective like that, like a marble. I think that's really cool. Okay, so let's add another node named bump node, and plug the normal to the normal, and let's clean up this space a little bit. Okay, so this time I'm gonna plug the color of noise texture to the height of the bump node, and it's too much, don't panic. Let's decrease the strength all the way down. It should be so subtle, the effect should be so subtle here. So I'm gonna just decrease that all the way down up to maybe there, and we can change the roughness a little bit as well. Okay, and there we go, it's our marble. And let's select this handle part and click on new, and I'm gonna call it handle, and this should be a PBR texture that I told you in the beginning of this video, the dark wood material. So I'm gonna bring the diffuse color, also the roughness and the displacement. So select all of them and bring them into the blender here, and let's plug the color of the diffuse color to the base color, and to make sure that sometimes they don't come in, you know, in turns, so its displacement should come be after the roughness, and it sometimes happens. Just make sure to look at the names, it's so important. So plug the roughness, color of roughness to the roughness, and just leave the displacement for now. I'm gonna add it later. So select one of them and press Ctrl T. And this time I'm gonna use the UV of the shape instead of the object or generated. And just plug the vector of the mapping node to all of these nodes here. The diffuse color, the normal and roughness, the displacement and roughness. And our texture is a wood texture, is this one, but as you see here, we have a just simple and solid color here. Why it's happening is because that we even didn't UV unwrap this model. So press Tab to go to edit mode and press A to select everything, and if you press U, the UV mapping menu will open up to you, and you'll have lots of ways to UV unwrap the model. You can go just adding some mark seams and unwrap it yourself manually, but I just found out that cube projection will work for tutorial very well. So look at this effect, it's amazing. But we have to just rotate that in Z direction 90 degrees. So select this and change and type 90, and there you go. So about the roughness color, we have to change the color space from linear rec to the sRGB. In that case, it will have this effect. Look at this effect, I really like this. So let's change the color a little bit. It's too saturated. I don't want that saturated pictures. So press Shift A and bring a hue saturation node and plug in between the diffuse color and principal PSDF. And all you need to do here is just to decrease the saturation a bit, maybe around 0.6 or 0.5 is okay. And now it's time to add the displacement texture. So press Shift A and add a search for the displacement node and plug the color to the height and plug the displacement to the displacement. And there you go. Let's zoom in a little bit. You see we have a strong effect here, but it's so strong. Let's reduce the scale all the way up to maybe 0.08, like that. Look at the effect. I really like it. And let's add another color ramp here. After adding the displacement, our roughness is ruined a little bit, so we have to control it ourselves. Let's make it a little bit shiny, like that. Look at the effect. It's amazing, isn't it? So I'm going to use the same texture with the stick part as well. Let's just select that and select this one, the handle part, and press Ctrl L and click on link materials here and press and select that itself and come to this part, select on this two button. In that case, it will take another copy of that and we can just change it without changing the previous one. So it doesn't have any, you know, UV unwrapping, so it is looking a little bit weird. So press Tab again to go to edit mode, press A to select everything and press U and again cube projection, and there you go. So you have a nice UV unwrapping here as well. So let's add another node here in between the hue saturation and principal PSDF. Press Shift A and search for RGB curves and plug it here and bring it a little bit higher. I'm gonna make it even more desaturated, just like that, and make it lighter, like that. Look at this effect. It's so brilliant. And let's decrease the color ramp. We have to make it a little bit rough, like that. And there you go. So let's select this, what it's called, this plane here, and click on new. I'm gonna call it maybe background BC and change the color to a some kind of bluish color. Press zero again here to see it properly. And let's add the last light here. So let's change it to 3D report and press Shift A and bring a point light and press 3 to see it from the side orthographic view and press G and Y, bring it all the way up to the end of this wand here. And it's not visible yet because it's inside of the wand. So come to the data part and change the radius, like that, and increase the power a little bit, and we can change the color to any color you want. If you want to cast a Avada Kedavra spell, you should make it green like this, and I really like it. Look at this. So let's change it to render PV as well. And there you go, this tutorial is done here. I hope you've enjoyed and learned a lot of things from this two episode Harry Potter 1 tutorial. And I can't wait to see your artworks and different type and styles of your wands. And feel free to send them to me at chaakoraa.production@gmail.com after you've modeled and finished your artworks. And if you're not a subscriber and haven't subscribed yet in the channel, just click on the button below to subscribe in the channel and hit the bell in the case of getting the notifications. So see you on the next videos. Goodbye.